तो फॉर टुडेज टॉपिक आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉप 3 बिजनेस इमिग्रेशन रूट। As an introduction, I would like to first tell you about the topic that I'm going to discuss with you and why do we discuss this information. So one of the prime reason that we discuss this information is that because a lot of our clients are misinformed. Information is like now in this world, it's like an infodemic, and we try to save you from that wrong information, give you the correct information, because not many people know that there are alternatives to business immigration, there are alternatives to your immigration need, and why the need of being global is so important. In future, whenever we make videos, I'm also going to discuss about these needs of becoming a global person and how many queries we have received in the COVID situation and how much we have been able to help our clients get that successful plan B. So for today's topic, I'm going to discuss the top 3 business immigration routes that you can look into as an alternative for your business establishment and how you can even get permanent residency through it. And believe you me, it's very much possible. We do it all the time. There are questions that client come up with the Google information, but then you need an experienced lawyer dealing with it and who will help you strategize the whole situation. So the first business immigration route, which has been very successful even in 2020 during the times of COVID, was the intra-company transfer. Now, what is an intra-company transferee and how does that happen is altogether another video that we have been making, and I will share the link in the description box about the ICT work permit. But you need to understand that this is a work permit which is basically going to get you to Canada through your country's own business, like the company that you might have in your home company, which is the parent company, and then you can either open a branch, affiliation, or a subsidiary of that company in Canada and come on a work permit here in Canada. Now, what happens is that once you are coming on that work permit to Canada, you will not get permanent residency immediately. So you have to take care of this in mind. The intra-company work transferee permit has a lot many benefits, and one of them includes that you can be of any nationality, you can be sitting anywhere across the globe, and we can help you get you here in Canada on that work permit. These are basically executive work permits. So for example, the intra-company work permit, and then there is another significant benefit work permit to Canada, that is the C-11. Now these work permits, they are LMI exempted, because I understand that people ask me the question that how can I get a work permit and still the job might not be LMI approved, because these are country treaties. Canada has a treaty with so many countries. Canada is a member nation of GATS agreement. Canada is a member nation of NAFTA, CETA. So all these treaties help you get an LMI exempted work permit. So it is very important to understand and have the knowledge of the kind of immigration route that you're opting for. Now, coming to the second option that I think is very, very promising, and we've been able to get positive results. Even I've shared it on my LinkedIn account. So what is the owner-operator work route? The detailed video of how you can immigrate through the owner-operator work route is in the description box. Mr. Shahrukh talks about it in detail, but I'm just going to give you a gist about the whole program. In owner-operator program, there are two steps. Now, first is you either buy or establish your business here in Canada. So buying is obviously expensive than establishing a business, but how you can prove activity in establishing a business successfully and getting an LMI approval for that is also one of the main strategy that you have to look into. Why I say that? Because 99% if you are getting a rejection by the ESDC officer is because you do not have activity in your company. So how you can have a startup with minimum investment and how you can immigrate to Canada through this route is completely a different ballgame altogether. Now to do this, one key thing I always tell my clients is that first make up your mind. Do you really want to come and run a business, or do you want to come and start a business of your own, or you want to buy a running business? You have to make up your mind. Now, I tend to understand that sitting from outside, sitting in Dubai, sitting in India, sitting in Pakistan, anywhere, you do not want to put a 200,000 investment in Canada company and then, you know, just do not know how the company actually might help you. So I tend to always tell that have an establishment or a startup of your business. So we do have a team, and as lawyers, we ourselves tend to help you a lot in that whole process and get you a positive LMIA approval. Now, one thing is, the first step is getting the approval from ESDC, and the second step is basically getting you a work permit or immediately updating your express entry profile, because you know you got an LMIA approved work permit, so you can also get PR points in that. Either it can be 50 or it can be 200. If you make 50 and still do not come in the express entry cutoff list, then what will happen is that you will come to Canada on that work permit and you will get experience points. Once you get those experience points, you are definitely going to make it through the express entry cutoff. There is no if and but about it, but there are certain things that you have to take into account, like you have to keep your company running, you have to pay government taxes. This is not a very purposeful program for tax purposes, but none of the business immigration programs can help you in tax purposes, because in Canada usually the tax bracket is there, and that is why so many public health benefits free education and other benefits that you have to take into account. Now, well, let's come to the third program that I really suggest my clients for 2021 is the Startup Visa Program. Now, why I talk about Startup Visa Program as the third program is because of the simple reason, because of investment. Now, this is for somebody who is an entrepreneur himself. Maybe he's got an innovative idea, maybe there is something unique business that he's already doing outside and he wants to come to Canada through the startup. Now, did you know that the federal government supports by about $26 billion budget for startups in Canada? Because Canada is a very, especially the Toronto and the Waterloo region, are very friendly tech startup environment, giving you all that incubation needs that you need for your business, be it any kind of, you know, be it the first round of seed investment, be it angel investors, be it venture capitalists, be it just an acceleration that you need to your running business. So you have to understand what not everything will work for everybody. So you have to understand that what kind of immigration need you need. Now in a startup, what typically happens is that if you are an entrepreneur and who's an innovator and who's got a very unique idea, can come to us with that idea and we will guide you through the whole process, that whether you need to do certain technical changes, certain cloud-based changes in your program, certain software changes, what you need to do. We have a dedicated team for that and we help you with your startup ideas. Now, if you are an investor and looking to look into a startup, then there are also options for you. You can invest in a startup. We have so many companies at the similar time for the startup program, and we tend to match and validate the process. Now, once the principal applicant and the group are together validated, then we send the group to the incubator or the angel investor from wherever you might want to get your letter of support, and if they approve, once the approval is done, once the due diligence stage is done, you get a commitment certificate calling you as an essential worker, and through that you get the permanent residency. Now I understand that there is too much of information, but then you should always leave it to the specialist. Why specialist? Because every program has its unique and essential component to it, which you need to fulfill. And all this is only, remember, through documentation. Because Canada is not likely to take your interview. It's like very less chances that the Canadian government takes your interview. So everything has to be in proper form of documents, be it your audit reports, be it your financials, be it your specialization certificates, or any kind of skill-based anything that we have to prove to them, we do it all. So these, according to me, are the top three programs through which you can immigrate to Canada. I will also soon be making a detailed video on the difference between an ICT work permit and a C11 work permit. In the meantime, if you have any queries, questions, or follow-up questions from this YouTube blog, then please write to us. I'm sharing the link in the description box. You also have a WhatsApp number for us to contact us in the description box. Me and my team are efficiently delivering these positive results from here in Canada. And soon we're also launching up in many other parts of the world. So I hope you like it. And if you do, then hit the like button and get in touch with us. As we always say, migrate with ACE.